With Norm Macdonald, and you can see it April 12th on Comedy Central. Here he is, the always entertaining Norm Macdonald, ladies and gentlemen. I saw that show today, Norm. Very funny.
What show? The TV show?
Yeah, your TV show.
Congratulations.
And by the way, you look very youthful. And how come we haven't seen you in 2 years?
Oh, how come I haven't been here in 2 years?
Yeah.
Oh, man, I've been busy. Well, I got a kid, you know.
I know. Well,
you got a kid.
Yeah, I do.
How old's Harry?
He's 7.
Yeah, yeah. Man, they grow up so slow. You know, don't you? It's barely discernible. Isn't it?
Yes, how old is your son?
He's 18. They get far less cute.
Yeah.
They're not as, cute when they're out on the lawn punching you in the chest.
Yeah, well, anyway, it's good to have you here.
Oh, it's good to be here,
and,
man.
In addition to the new show, the Norm Macdonald Sports Show, was it your first stand-up special?
Yes, I did a Comedy Central special.
Great.
One of 40 they did this year on Comedy Central. But it was fun, but I got a weird time. They showed it at 11:30 and on Saturday, and it turned out that that was during this thing called Earth Hour. I think some people know what it is.
Yeah.
On Earth Hour, you have to turn off your electricity. So.
Wow. That's horrible.
And as you know, and yeah. As I know, and as they apparently know, TVs are powered by electricity. So, and furthermore, my key demographic is damn dirty hippies.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Well, you know, what are you going to do?
Took one on the chin there.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, listen, I'm very surprised and impressed about this, that you've built kind of like a Twitter following.
Yes, yeah, so, well, I'm an internet sensation.
Whoa. Now, I didn't take you for a guy that would know about that kind of stuff.
I know all about that stuff.
Really?
Man.
When did you start Twitter?
2 weeks ago.
Really?
But this is what I know. I did it for the Oscars. The guy told me how to do it, and I was watching the Oscars, mm-hmm. And you know how horrible those were. And so it was pretty easy to do just jokes constantly on how horrible everyone was, you know? And some of the things were nice, like it was nice to see Kirk Douglas, of course, mm-hmm. You know? And he had that terrible stroke, which didn't affect his comic timing at all.
Mm-hmm.
So I Twittered, and I ended up Twittering 190 tweets.
Whoa.
And which is, it turns out, is way too much.
Really?
So people started telling me to stop. Anyways, Get this. Just earlier, this happened. Right before we came on the show, I walked out here.
Yeah.
I'm in some kind of Twitter feud with Steve Martin.
I know that Steve also actively Twitters.
Yeah, yeah. So this is what happened. Dig this. You know how to tweet?
No.
You don't know how to tweet?
No.
Where you been? He writes a tweet. I misunderstand it. I reply.
Well, let's hear what he says.
What he said?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, this is what he said. I'm not really that great at it. But he said, has anybody seen my hat?
Mm.
Now, I'm looked everywhere for it. I can't find my hat.
Right.
So I say, was it a brown fedora with a red hat band? But what I didn't know is he sent a twit pic.
Stop right there. Let me just say, if this is an example of Twitter communication, it's invaluable.
What do you think I should answer him? This is the last thing he said to me. He goes, this just came in 9 seconds ago. He goes, still mulling over this tweet from Norm to me. It's so enigmatic. Is it a put down?
I mean, he lost a hat, right?
Yeah.
And then you responded, is it with a red hat band?
Yeah.
I don't, none of this makes any sense.
It's a generational thing.
Oh, that's but, yeah. I guess so. Well, what is it?
Now, I will tell you what's cool about the internet and being an internet sensation and stuff. On the YouTube now, everybody, you know, I don't know if you remember, but there's Andy, did you ever hear the Andy Williams quote, in the future, everybody will be famous for 25 minutes?
Yes. Yeah. I think it was Andy Warhol. Huh? Andy Williams was Moon River.
Oh.
Andy, well, it's a generational thing. Yeah, okay.
But here's the thing. Like, for instance, have you ever heard of Harrison Schmitt?
No.
Okay. He walked on the moon.
I didn't know that.
Right. An astronaut.
Right.
A guy who walked on the moon. There's very few people that have been in the position to go, hey, where's the moon? There it is.
Right. Well, you're right. That's a good point.
Right. Now, so 12 people have landed on the moon. Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin. Who else?
Right.
So this Harrison Schmitt fellow must be going, what the hell do I have to do to get famous?
Yeah.
Right? Meanwhile, the Kardashians, we know Khloe, we know...
It's awful.
Yeah, Lois.
Lois Kardashian.
All of them.
We'll be right back with Norm Macdonald, everybody. You can tweet Steve Martin. Can you tweet him right now?
I can tweet him, yeah.
Or just tell him that I said hi.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And that you're on the show and we're talking about him. And
okay, awesome.
I said hi.
Awesome.
And, oh, add this. I'm sorry about the hat.
You know what's great also while I do this? I'll tell you this. The great thing about the blogosphere...
Mm-hmm.
Now, the great thing is this, that you you have friends, you see what I mean?
Yeah.
Now, on the computer, I have about 160,000 friends.
Whoa.
In real life, I have two. But I actually like my I like my friends on the blogosphere here, because this is the thing. Like, they can go, like in real life, right? Your friend will go, hey, my grandmother died this morning. And then you go, oh, good. Do you want to come over to my house and talk about it for 4 hours?
Mm-hmm.
And then on this thing, your friend can go, hey, my grandmother died today. And then you go, unfollow.
Mm-hmm. Now, Norm, are you? Do I remember that you were?
I'm talking to Steve Martin.
Okay, I'm sorry. I mean, if you just get that over to him by Labor Day, that'd be. Do you still gamble? Somebody told me that you did. You or did we know that?
Yeah, I used to gamble.
You don't gamble anymore.
No, I gamble anymore.
Was it a problem? Did it get to be a problem?
Yeah, it got to be a problem, man. And then I tried to do it smart. Every time I tried to do it smart, a bad thing would happen.
Like,
you know?
What do you mean?
Well, one time I was trying to handicap baseball, you know, which you can actually beat baseball if you handicap it properly. So I was trying to handicap, and I figured it out for like 3 hours, and I went down to the book in Mirage, the sports book, went up to the fella, you know, and there was a guy beside me, big fat guy, you know, and he was dressed like real rich, you know, and he opened a big attaché case filled with $10,000 chips, pulls out like $750,000, and he's going to bet on this boxer, you know, a fighter, you know?
Yeah.
And it was a 4-to-1 underdog. So I said, I'm not going to bet my baseball bet. I'll just bet on this 4-to-1 underdog, you know?
Because he must know something.
Yeah, because this guy must know something. He's probably in the mafia.
Mm-hmm.
So I go and watch the boxing match, Dave, and the guy, my guy that I bet on, gets knocked out in 25 seconds.
Oh, no. Whoa. Yeah.
So I go back to the book. I go, well, that guy from the mafia, what? He goes, that guy's not from the mafia. He goes, that's old long shot Louie. He goes... He's a rich guy. He loves long shots.
Well, there's just no winning, is there?
No, there's no winning. Nobody ever wins.
Now, this sports show, with Norm MacDonald, premieres. You know, it's my birthday, April 12th.
That's your birthday?
I saw it this afternoon. Very funny show, and I think it's going to be a huge hit for you.
You want to hear a sports joke?
Yeah.
Oh, you like racing cars, right? Yeah. How about that Daytona 500? Yeah. How about that kid that won?
Right.
How old was he?
Like 20?
Yeah, yeah. He raced all around. You know why he went so fast, apparently? He was texting the whole time. It's generational.
The show premieres April 12th on Comedy Central. Sports show with Norm MacDonald. Great pleasure to see you.
It's great
Don't wait two years to come back. On the back of CC Sabathia, ladies and gentlemen.
Hank Williams, you came all over.